My man Jazzy Jeff, much love, man. I appreciate you, boy. New York, I'm glad we got an eclectic crowd, man, because there's a lot of black people here. I want to thank the white people for coming. You must show that you still know your place. It's awesome you came with that kind of confidence. Is that your man? Okay, how you doing, bro? Don't unfold your arms. Why are you looking at me like you the rent collector? Unfold your arms. You a big mother. I throw a weight down. You got to make a choice, mother. So is this your first Negro? That bitch said, mm-mm. I said this shit like he come with a theme song. My first Negro. Yes. Y'all probably have great sex. Are y'all role playing all? Is he role playing? Yeah. You ever play Escape Slave and the Master's Wife? This shit. Hurry up, get back to work. You on the clock. Shit, you got a white girl, you gotta dress up like OJ Halloween, guy in the closet with a bunch of knives, scared of shit. Ah! I'm glad y'all together, that's fun. Look, let me tell you something. When y'all have sex, because you gotta role play, it's fun. You know what I'm saying? Like, black women, don't get me wrong, I love y'all, but certain shit can't do with y'all. Y'all have too many rules and regulations. Shit. Don't touch my hair. Don't mean touch my motherfucking hair. I just got my shit did. You dog said he gotta keep his hands behind his back and shit. You feel the urge to grab your shit. It might come off like, oh shit. You gotta have a chin strap on. You gotta keep it locked down, man. You gotta have fun with that, man. Like, I noticed I got a pretty Asian girl sitting in the crowd. How you doing, sweetheart? You all right? Yes, baby. Bitch, I'm looking at you. Yes, this ain't, yes, you, my. How you doing, sweetheart? I love Asian women. See, I can have fun with you if you was my girl. We could role play, you know? Like, I come home one day in a soldier's outfit. And I got my dick hanging through the zipper. And I'm like, I'm an American soldier here to slay some... What's your nationality, baby? What's your nationality? You Filipino? It'd work better for the joke if you're Vietnamese. So you're Vietnamese. Like, I'm an American soldier here to slay some Vietnamese ass. And I can't see you. You're somewhere in the house hidden, but you got like a potato sack on for a shirt. A little dirt and mud on your face. And I just hear you yell from a distance, "You go home, black man, this is my new war." And then when I see you, we on a bed of rice patties. That would be awesome, man. Don't get embarrassed, it's real shit, man. And I don't want none of the white people to get uncomfortable, because I do like to talk about the race issue, because a lot of y'all try to act like that shit ain't relevant no more. Like, is race still relevant in America? Look at some of the white people. Whatever do you mean? Racism will always be relevant in America for two reasons. One, it's just too much bad history, and you can't erase that much bad history. And two, I just think it's natural for everybody to be a little bit racist. I don't give a what color you are, what your gender is, how old you are, we are all a little bit racist. And white people, y'all are the first ones to denounce it. I'm not racist. I'm incapable of being racist. My best friend is black. He's also my chauffeur, but he's my best friend. Everybody in this room, everybody in this country is a little racist. You might not be smack a taco out of Mexican hand racist, but we are all... funnier than that. I don't know why y'all scared to laugh. Y'all act like 300 Mexicans gonna pop out of nowhere like, what the I'll make a special sour cream for you, Ese. It's hilarious. And I live in LA. I love the Mexicans. I do. Because of Mexicans, my lawn looks fabulous. I got a little bit of money. I live in a white neighborhood. They be out there cutting my grass and shit. It be hot as a mother outside. I be standing from the house through the blinds. Like, 20 minutes later, they knock on the door and ask me for shit. Señor, it's hot outside. They all sound like Speedy Gonzalez. It's hot outside. Me and my compadres was wondering, can we have some agua? I'm like, nope, but I can give you some advice. Hum your way through it, motherfucker. That's how we got back. That you got to earn your turn. You can't just hop over a fence and expect the same rates. You got to earn your turn. Look at some of the white people. Oh my God, he said it. Thank you. I've been feeling this, black man. Thank you. And I know that's a big deal in this country. Illegal immigration. White people, you guys get bent out of shape over that shit. I hear you complain. Mexicans, they're coming here taking their jobs. Some of them have criminal records. We're not safe. We don't know who's among us. Well, let me remind all the white people, while you're steady being mad at the Mexicans, technically you guys were the first illegal immigrants. Because when you came to this country, it belonged to the Indians, and we know how that shit turned out. Look how quiet they got. Did you feel the tension all of a sudden? Did you feel it? They're like, I can't believe you would say that. We were just starting to like you. How could you betray our trust? Listen, I don't give a if you come to this country legally or illegally, because at the end of the day, we're all foreigners to some extent. My only issue is if you're going to come to this country, I got one rule. Learn how to speak English, please. You've got to learn the language. Because there is nothing more frustrating than me being at Popeye's Chicken, arguing with Jorge about what the I ordered. And I'm trying to catch the second half of the game. I ain't got time for this shit. You ever talk to somebody that don't know how to speak English? They always got a look and a sound coming out of their face. Like they in the middle of taking a shit. It's hilarious. Like, excuse me, you know what time it is? I don't speak in no prole. I don't. I was at Popeye's Chicken around the playoffs for basketball, and I'm arguing with this mother about my order. He didn't understand me. I didn't understand him. Shit was terrible. I was like, dog, let me get a two-piece chicken dinner. He tried to repeat the shit back to me. You want a two-piece yicky? Do you want the spicy or the mild? I said, what? He said, the spicy or the mild? I said, what the f- you know put mayonnaise on chicken? Why would I put mayonnaise on chicken? I'm a hot sauce. My daddy was a hot sauce. He said, no, the mild for the flavor. I said, what the f- is flavor? He kept looking at the menu like it was Family Feud and the answer was going to pop up on the board. I'm going to tell you the doopy chicken with the spicy and the mild, so you better get it for you. Said, let me get a two-piece chicken, spicy. He said, you want it busy? I said, yes, mother. I'm busy. I don't have time for this shit. I'm trying to catch the game. Kobe's on. Come on. You say, no, it's busy. I said, what the is it busy? Chupura de body and the cream cheese. I said, a biscuit? He said, CZ is going to tell you with the doobie jiggy, which is spicy on the mouth. They're going to come with it busy, so you better get it for you. Andale, andale, iba, iba. Said, let me get a two-piece chicken spicy with a biscuit. He said, now you have to pickle your sides. I said, I'm not playing with my penis and Popeyes. I'm not doing that. Why would I pull my out near the crunchy? I'm not doing it. He said, no, you get two side order. I said, what kind of side you got? He said, we have a day. We have a day. It was we have the, but we have the, we have the macaroni and yeast. We have the yash potato. I said, Let me go with the yash potato. She wants something to drink. I said, what do you have to drink? Well, how about the... Well, how about the sodas and the uses? I said, I don't want no soda, but I'm curious about your uses. Funny thing is, you don't even realize how racist America is until after you leave. You know? Like, I did a show not too long ago in Edmonton, Canada. There is no racist vibe in Edmonton. Well, first of all, ain't no out there, so ain't nobody be mad at. But I must have walked around that for 4 days looking for a black person. Finally, I saw one. I ain't even know the motherfucker. I just ran up to him and hugged him. Like, where you been? We need to stick together. He was offended. He was like, dude, get your hands off of me, bro. It's like totally absurd. I was like, shit, they got him. It was too late. I couldn't save him. I had white kids looking at me like I was an exotic animal. It was like, mom, look at him. He's so chocolatey. I want one. I kept trying to pour milk on me. I was like, it ain't gonna change colors. Off me. And I see some of the white people, y'all getting uncomfortable. Don't get uncomfortable. I love white people, man. Y'all my people too. It's just certain shit I can't do with y'all. Like, go drinking. Every time I do a show in front of white people, after the show, y'all always want to hang out and buy me a drink. I can't drink with y'all. It's not that I don't want to, it's just I can't hang. You motherfuckers, the undisputed champs of drinking. Y'all drink till y'all fall the out. And I know when y'all get good and drunk, because that's that noise y'all make. Woo! Don't do that. That scare black folk. There's a lot of bad history behind that noise. Black people, we hear, woo! We start looking out for pickup trucks. Where the f*** they at? See, that's why I don't like f***ing with Earl. He played too much. I'm serious. A party ain't a party to y'all till the f***ing cops show up. And black people, y'all know, we see the police party over. White people, y'all have a freedom we just don't have. Y'all see the police, y'all get braver. Dude, what's your badge number and your name? No, don't touch me. What if I touch you? No, you shut the up and move along. Aries, why are you crying? Relax. Do you know who my dad is? I'll sue, I swear to God. Get the on. Black people, we be in the back doing sign language. Mm-hmm. And to any black people that hang out with white people in a group, make sure if y'all go out drinking in a group, go with them when they order drinks. Because y'all like to anoint somebody the designated drink orderer. Anytime I hang out with my white friends, when they get it from the table and go to the bar to get around, I follow right behind theirs. Because y'all like to go order drinks and then bring it back to us like it's the top CIA secret. As soon as you hand me the drink, I go, man, what the f*** is in this? Dude. Don't worry, don't ask. Just f***ing chug it. 20 minutes later, I'm butt naked with a cowboy hat on. Woo! I love you, Brad. Hey, just for fun, let's go hang some. Just keep it safe. So are we still excited about Barack Obama? See, every black person in here should be clapping. Because we got to ride that till the wheels fall off. You know, if that shit don't work, the minute we go to work, white folks is looking at us like, You picked him. I can't wait till he runs for his second term, man. Because that was the most exciting part about the political process to me was the campaign. Because you knew at some point he was supposed to win. He had all the right ingredients that came together at the right time. He's tall, good looking, articulate, highly intelligent, you know, smooth under pressure, charismatic. And most importantly, he was the right shade. He made white people feel comfortable. Because y'all know if that was Bernie Mac Black, or Precious Purple, he wouldn't have won. He's like coffee with cream. It goes down easy. You ever have coffee black? It's too strong. You'd be like, ooh. America is not ready for ooh. They're not ready yet. And he had 97% of the black vote, 97%, which means he had black people on lock. We were like a hand in a glove. We were tied together. But he still couldn't have become president without white people. So for the white people that voted for him, I thank you because you helped make history. But some of y'all are starting to get a little impatient, and your racism is seeping out a little bit. You say shit when you're frustrated. I thought you were fast. What's taking so long? Took 8 years to fuck this country up. It's gonna take a second to get it together. Relax. I'm actually on a mission, man, you know? Like, I don't even think comedy is my calling in life. I think I'm meant for something greater. Like, I had a vision the other night. It came to me. I think my mission in life is to help white people. Like, really, I want to feel comfortable enough to walk in your house unannounced at 3 o'clock in the morning. Just wake you up and go, come with me. Like comics, we don't do shit when we're on the road except stay in the hotel room and watch TV. And I'm flipping through some of the stations and I'm watching these programs like Oprah and Phil. And I'm seeing some of y'all's kids is out of control. I really want to ask white people, I've always been curious, why don't y'all just beat your kids, man? Beat them, whoop their mother ass. Y'all give y'all kids all kind of timeouts and special places. The is a special place. To a black child, that's a coma. What is a special place? Black kids don't know shit about timeout. We know about getting knocked the out. That's it. My mother used to slap the shit out of me in public, and I would look at people for help. Like, shut up. White people felt my pain. Oh, my God. She just struck her child. Black people see black kids get hit. We be like, hey, get your shit together. Black people will beat other people's kids if they them too bad. Like, miss, you need to whoop this ugly mother. Put that shit down. Here's my website, email, home address. Call me. I'll him up in the damn you need. You know what I found out growing up? Totally shocked me. White kids are just as shocked to find out black kids don't talk back to their parents as we are, and we're here to talk back to theirs. So I used to have a little buddy would come over my house on the weekends, little Nate. We'd be in my room playing video games. My mother used to come in the room on us, cuss me out for no reason. Just scare the shit out of both. We'd be in the room playing Mario Brothers. She'd come kick open the door like SWAT. We'd be on level 4. She'd, poof. Aries, how many times have I told you to clean this mother room? Cut that goddamn game off and clean this room. I come back, this mother room ain't clean. I'm gonna take that Nintendo cord, wrap it around your neck, and stick it in your ass. I ain't playing with you. This ain't no threat. This a promise. Try me, mother. Try me. My mother was a champ at whooping ass too, man. She had a gold belt and everything. I remember one time I stole a bike. And she had to leave her job to get me out of jail. You know, you grew up in a single parent household with a black woman and she got to leave work to get you out? I knew I was going to that special place. I knew the ass whooping was serious because when we got home, she took her work clothes off and put on a jogging suit and headband. Like, what kind of ass whooping is that you prepared to sweat? A stopwatch and a bottle of Gatorade with the belt. I said, at some point, this bitch is fitting to refuel on this ass whooping. I just always been envious of the relationship that white parents have with your kids, man. You guys actually have a democracy in your household. You actually care about your kids' opinions. Which is why you don't understand why they run rampant over you at the same time. I grew up with a lot of white kids. I'd hear their parents complain to mine. It was always the same argument. I don't understand why my child talks to me this way. Such disrespect. I don't know what to do. I'm at my wit's end. Problem is, a lot of you guys put your kids on the same level as you. You consider them your contemporaries. How you put somebody on the same level as you that can't pay the rent or the mortgage, put food in the refrigerator, or keep the lights on? They're not your contemporaries, they're your kids. Moral of the story, beat they mother ass. There's something about pain that makes mother listen. Like, I just saw this show, The Nanny. I could not believe this shit exists. Y'all have flown an English bitch in to tell you how to deal with your kids. And she always has some profound shit to say. You must ignore the child's behavior, but not the child. The f*** out of here. They should redo that show. Call it The Nanny. It'd be 3 minutes long. She showed up to the door. Boom, boom. Where the mother at? Pow. Show over. Theme song. The Nanny. That's it. No commercial breaks. One episode. It's over. I like to smoke weed and watch National Geographic. Because I like the Nature Channel. Like, I want to go to Africa one day, go on a safari, see the animals in their natural habitat. But the difference between us and y'all is we stay in the truck. White people, y'all got some shit called up close and personal. Like, it's amazing, too, because that's what black people, we just know certain shit, you know? Like, white people, that's why I study y'all, envy y'all. I'm envious of y'all. Y'all are a race. Y'all do whatever the y'all want to do. Y'all, you know, y'all are free. Y'all are the only race of people that could look at a wild lion and go, I can be friends with that. That's why y'all are always on when animals attack. You will never see black people on when animals attack. You might see us on when cops attack, but you will never see us on when animals attack. Y'all would do shit like tranquilize a lion and hold that motherfucker till he wake up. And that'd be heavy shit to y'all. Y'all be in the camera. Well, my partner Bob and I, we've been tracking this particular beast for quite some time. Her name is Utulu. She's 6 months old. We just shot her with 5 cc's of tetracordylene darts. But she gets up, she's gonna be pissed. Oh my God, Bob, do you feel your heart pounding? This is amazing. Oh my God, she's getting a wow. She mauled me. What an experience. The Africans don't be out there with the lions. They ask him, Mr. Matumbu, why you don't play with the lion? I'm not with that muddy you. That shit is not in the brochure. I'm not doing that shit. When my shift is over, I want to go home to my children. Mangulu, Mongala, and I can't do anything with that. When the shit rot, you better come, I will leave you in the car. It's rules. Ain't no African people here, is it? Are you African, dog? My bad. I want to piss you off and you mother. You know what's f***ed up? African people don't like black people. Y'all know they treat us like shit. They talk down to us. They think they better than us. And I don't understand, because we from the same tribe, kind of. But they like white people, though. They treat y'all like family. As soon as y'all come around, they get excited. Excuse me, Mr. White Man. Thank you for bringing us here. We love you. Yay, the white man. As soon as they see us, they get an attitude. Hey, how you doing? This we don't like the black man in America. Mother, you don't work, you don't do shit. We don't like you, you black mother. Like, who are you calling black mother? I'm brown, you midnight. Who the are you calling black? Like, if you stood up against a building, you'd look like an alley. Who the f- are you calling black? This shit is unjust. African men don't understand why when they come to America, they have a hard time getting American. You can't be that aggressive with American women, especially black women. You gotta know how to talk. You gotta come correct. Motherfuckers and Africans used to having their way. They got 15 wives and shit. And African women are very obedient. They tell their women what to do. It's not even an issue. Bitch, when they come home, you... I don't know why they do that. You better clean the shit from the floor. They be in the club stalking women out here. You can't even see them. They be as black as my jacket. As soon as you go buy your drink, they jump out the shadows and scare the shit out of you. Bitch, what is your name? Come here. Don't run from me. You're going to be my wife. Monaya, Monaya. Monaya, what? They're hunters. It's instant. I think that's the key to racism, though. You gotta be willing to invest in other people's cultures. So at the end of the day, I don't give a what color you are. Everybody got something to bring to the table. And life is short, man. Sample that shit. You don't know what you might be missing. Why deprive yourself of a great human experience because you mad? It's ridiculous. So I appreciate a good culture. I appreciate a good accent. You got the right accent, you can get away with a lot of shit. You be in a club and say something foul to a woman in an American accent, she might slap the shit out of you. Like, excuse me, baby, I don't mean to bother you, but you got a fat ass. I love to take you home, the shit out you. Mother English accent, that just roll off the tongue different. Excuse me, I don't mean to bother you, but I really love to take you back to my hotel and eat doggy stuff a little bit, you know what I mean? Mother where you from? That's say something else. Ladies, you're laughing. Some of the fellas might try that on the way home. Just have a good time at the comedy shows, you know. Is it really? The next light, because you give me a little bit of head, just a little bit. I don't want much. Just want you to polish me now, you know what I mean? I ain't even gonna lie. I'll use that shit to get some. I'll walk up to a woman and say anything. Excuse me, you know what time it is? Oh my God, your accent is beautiful. Where are you from? I just make shit up. McDonald's, England. Have you ever heard of it? I live right off of Egg McMuffin Lane. Have you ever heard of it? Oh my God, girl, you live off of Egg McMuffin. That's good. Like, I'm really trying to make it in Hollywood. Like, I want to be a movie star. That's my dream. But I'm finding out Hollywood is not what you think it's about. People move out to L.A. thinking this shit is about talent. Shit is not about talent. It's about sex appeal. It's part of my game I got to work on. Gotta be in shape to be a movie star, man. You know, my problem is I like cupcakes too much. I'm serious. Sometimes on a Saturday night, if I got a choice between some and a cupcake. Sometimes cupcake wins. It's kind of like if you think about it, especially if you heat it up in the microwave for 15 seconds. It's all warm on the inside, creamy in the middle. And when it's over, it's much easier to wash that smell off your dick. I'm trying to tell you. Y'all, funny to me. I don't give a funny to me. It's hard for blacks to make it in Hollywood too, man, because the rules are different. You know, Hollywood, you gotta be humble no matter what color you are. But if you're black, you really gotta be humble, you know? Because sometimes it don't matter how good you are. I remember I had lunch with Chris Rock one time. He gave me the best advice. He was like, look, man, all I can tell you is, one, keep writing, and two, try not to piss these white folks off. Because that shit is true. It don't matter how good you are. If you're angry, if you're the angry black man, they don't f*** with you. Case in point, Paul Mooney. This motherfucker is a legend. Everybody, y'all know Paul Mooney. This wrote for Richard Pryor and Eddie Murphy. You a bad mother when you writing for other bad mother. The problem with Paul is Paul will tell you he's a bad mother. He'll shoot himself in the foot. I remember one time I tried to get him to do a job for MADtv. I wanted him to be a writer. I said, yo, we already a great show, but Paul, he'll take us to the next level. Paul will go into the meeting and shoot himself in the foot. As soon as he walked in, the producers were like, Paul, Aries recommends you highly. He thinks you're great. Let me ask you, are you familiar with our show? Paul went right into it. I've seen your show. All of your stolen my material. You've all stolen from me. I've seen it. It doesn't matter. No, homie, listen. In Living Color, Saturday Night Live, you all have stolen my shit. First you stole, then you stole my material. And in case you didn't know, I invented comedy. I invented it. And then later on, I'll see Paul and go, Paul, how did it work? Homie, they're not gonna hire me. I'm too real. They're scared of me, homie. I'm too real. Trust me. They love to grin. When you grin, you win. All the grin, win. Look at the Wayne Brady. They love that. That grins. That has a hairdo from the 50s. He wears a perm. He's a throwback. They love him. Homie, it's true. White folks will tell you, why can't you be more like Wayne? We love Wayne. They love grinning. What about that other that played basketball for the Lakers, that he owns businesses, that with AIDS, Magic Johnson? They love that grinning. That grinned his way through AIDS. It's true. Have you ever seen that grin? It's from temple to temple. It's huge. That looks like the cat from Alice in Wonderland. They love that. Here's the thing. If you're not grinning, they'll talk about you. It scares white folks. It scares them. I remember one time I was on a lot, and they said, good morning, Paul. And I didn't grin. I just nodded my head. They talk about you. Why is that not grinning? That doesn't he know where he is? That should be grinning. And if you grin too fast, you scare white folks. I said good morning to a white woman. I grinned real fast. That bitch was scared. I said good morning. She said, wow. That bitch took off winning. It's true. Is that gay? It's true.
They love it.
You gotta be humble, man. It's crazy, man. Like, I got a lot of respect for the art, man, you know? Like, I love all them kind of movies. Like, my favorite movies are them Gladiator movies. Like, Gladiator with Russell Crowe, Troy with Brad Pitt, Braveheart. I don't even like it for the action and the violence. I like it for the dialogue. That's some smooth shit, the way they talk in the movies. It's like they got their own language. You've heard it before. My lord. It's my lord, but that's how they say it. My lord. Let it be known that Xerxes is a kind god king, and he offers this declaration as an alternative to war. Now let me speak with the nobles, or I will engage with my military. It's military, but military. The other character is always some pompous, arrogant asshole. Prometheus, please spare me of your banality. This is not about war. This is about my daughter's hand in marriage. So neither try to seduce me, nor bore me with the belligerence of your insolence. I'll be in the theater eating my popcorn like, goddamn, who got diabetes? There's some in here that don't even think I said anything wrong. Like, my grandmama got the insolence. Like, that's one of my fantasies. Like, I want to role play like that. Call my girl up one time and be like, look, baby, don't cook nothing. I'm going to come home, pretend to be a Roman warrior. And we're going to send our son out to the store so I have some time alone to seduce you. And I come in the house talking that shit. Wretched is how I feel as I spew these words of hostility from my lips. There you are, Lakeisha. The beauty of my seduction. How I long to ravish the concubines of your clavicle. But first I must silence these roars that stem from my belly due to hunger. For it is only fit for a king to dine on the killing of a carcass after a day of duly wages. There he is, my son, my seed, my young loin. The mirrored me that spawns from the spew of my male mayonnaise. I want you to take these medals of currency and go down to the local marketplace and trade them for a feast of yeast and wine. Now, hither away before the third planet from the sun is played by darkness at a command from the higher lords. As for you, my love, only when darkness is among us will I shower you with the fire that burns deep underneath my cloak. For only your seduction can force me to fall to bended knee and sip the wet, spicy nectar which flows from the purr of your kitty cat. She's like, huh? I'm like, bitch, I'm trying to eat your I need you to follow me and keep up. I can't work under these conditions. And I respect the art. Like, I get upset when I hear about these actors that get paid $20 million a movie to act. And the key word is act. But they pay the seduce who never come. How do you pay Stallone and Schwarzenegger $20 million a movie? Pay that to the dudes who deserve it, like Pacino, De Niro, Denzel, Morgan. This is a f***ing actress, man. Because to this day, one of my favorite movies of all time is Heat with Pacino and De Niro. Anybody that's ever seen the movie knows what I'm talking about. It's like they took the two greatest actors of all time and put them in a scene together. If you've never seen the movie, go rent it, smoke a joint. It's great. You got that scene where they meet for the first time and Pacino's sitting there with De Niro. He's bringing shit down to him. He's like, you, sir, are a bad guy. I am the police. It's my job to stop guys like you. Murderers, rapists, killers. It's what I do. There may come a time when our paths cross. I'm gonna have to take you down. I won't like it, but I'll do it. Keeps me hot on my toes. Where I gotta be. De Niro comes back. No, there's a flip side to that coin. A friend of mine, Jimmy, once told me, never get attached to anything that you cannot walk out on in 15 seconds flat if you spot the heat coming around the corner. And I also like guys like you that like guys like me because you keep me hot on my toes. Where I gotta be. And you're right, our paths, they may cross. I'm gonna have to take you down. I won't like it, but I will not. Hesitate. Great scene. Now hold up. Picture the same scene with Stallone and Schwarzenegger. You ain't gonna be able to understand shit. Stallone is doing what you're. You know there's a flip side to this coin. I'm gonna have to take it down. I won't like it, but I'll do it. Even deaf people are like, what is that? What is that? Can you imagine him asking this woman for head? Maria, come on, give me head, go down. Don't come up for air, lift your ears. Fellas, you want a freaky woman out during sex? Make that noise, or the f*** up. You be hitting from the back. What is wrong with you? Don't worry about what's going on up here. Put your head down. Ladies, it'll work for you too. You don't want to get your man head? Do that. It'll stop immediately. As soon as you get down there. Bitch, what the f***? What you making, keys or something? No, you ain't gonna put a handicap sign on my balls. I'm good to go. That's a good noise to make if you want privacy in a public bathroom. You will clear that mother right out. As soon as you get in there. Sir, you all right? Get down, get away. It's going to be an explosion. Get to the chopper now. I don't know why he says that. He says that in every movie. Get to the chopper now. I like to make that noise on a crowded elevator, especially if I got the fart. People just assume there's something wrong with me. As soon as I rip one, oh my God, what was that? Smell it, it's nasty, smell it. Get to the chopper, get down. Oh my God, his he didn't even have a helmet on. You know what's funny? Some of y'all are laughing, but some of y'all are gonna go home and tonight. And when you gonna do that, it's gonna be hilarious. Like, girl, I know you. I'm finished. Get me a paper towel. Come here. Find me down. Get to the chopper. Now. Don't drink and drive, because if you get pulled over, that's exactly how you sound. Sir, have you been drinking? Hell. I had the Jaeger and Patron to the top of now. We're going to need backup. And apparently we need a chopper. I don't know why, but... I actually
met Arnold Schwarzenegger, man. True story. I was doing a show in San Jose, California. And it's like a 5.5 hour drive outside of LA. And I stopped at a Chevron, and this motherfucker was on pump number 7, filling up his H2. Now, I don't really get starstruck. Like, if this had been Van Damme or Seagal, I'd have been like, whatever. This is Terminator. This is Conan. Like, I grew up on this motherfucker. And I saw him, and I was so excited. I was like, yo, Arnold, man, I love your shit. He didn't even look at me. He was just like, yeah, how are you? And I called my boy, and I said, he ain't gonna believe it. Arnold Schwarzenegger is on pump number 7, filling up. He was like, you lying. I said, I swear to God. He was like, Arnold Schwarzenegger? I said, And Arnold heard me, and I swear he went just like this. It's like his Marco Polo. He understood. It was like a mating call. He knew. Some of the fellas might remember where I got that. Remember the scene in Predator when he got ready to fight the alien and he covered himself with mud? He's like, I'm here. Kill me. Come on. Do it. Shit. I want to talk about the state of hip-hop for a second. Because I'm a big hip-hop fan, man. I just feel like, you know, a lot of this southern rap is dominating hip-hop. And I don't want to hate on these brothers, man, because, you know, I'm happy to see any black man in America getting money. It's a beautiful thing, you know. But some of these southern brothers, man, a lot of these southern rappers, man, need to step their game up. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, you talk about, like, New York, we've dominated rap for a long time. And I know a lot of southern people feel like, you know, New Yorkers are bitter. But come on, man, we birth rap. We started it in the South Bronx. And lyrics is part of the game. You know, like Ludacris, T.I., Lil Weezy. I love them, man. T.I. is my favorite. Andre 3000, one of the best lyricists in the game. But a lot of these southern they'd be making these singy-songy, catchy songs that five-year-olds could dance to. Come on, man. Quit that Dr. Seuss shit. Y'all got to step y'all game up. Because it seems like nowadays, if you come up with any song, it don't matter what the lyrics are. You get you a southern, you know, catchy beat, you could spit bullshit, and it's a hit. I know I got one. So I'm going to introduce y'all to my southern rap character, Big Bugga Boogaloo. And his hit song, a book, look at my dance. I can show you better than I can tell you. Yeah. Yeah. It's going down, mate. We about to make this motherfucker pop up on her. Get the dirty south. Yeah. Fake a bitch.
Look at my dance from the dirty south, doing what we do, making it rain with the strippers in the club. Pop that booty, baby, drop it low. It's a recession, we got a mad hole. Got the 67 candy Chevy, drop it to the floor. When I come through the hood, everybody know the kids know I'm rich. They say that I'm the man. So up front, got the bitches in the trunk. Police damn foul. My mama say I'm reckless. Who else you know about a chicken chain necklace? That's right, chicken chain necklace. And I wear this motherfucker wrong, cause when I be rhyming, I be heating up this motherfucker cook. When I'm hungry, I eat this son of a bitch. I be like, hey baby, lean with it, rock with it, Superman, whoa, it's all the same shit, just dance to the floor, only got one man, and this be my man, will I say my man, he really my man, I rap so hard from the north to the south, got a ring full of head and a gold full of mouth, huh, wait a minute, how you gonna have a ring of hand? Club in North Carolina. I gave a bitch a dollar, but then she was pregnant. 9 months, that turned me off. So I took the money back. Do you know before I put that money in my pocket, a baby hand came out of and snatched the dollar back.
Thank you. I appreciate it, baby. I appreciate the love. Thank you very much.